User experience is one of the biggest points of emphasis for Dewesoft software. Dewesoft X 2020 takes an already mature product and refines it even more. One of the key principles for providing a better user experience is consistency. That means that similar design concepts should be used across the whole software in order to make it feel like a cohesive unit. With X3, we've introduced the same grid across almost all modules, and with Dewesoft X 2020, we've updated the whole icon pack to fit with the overall theme and have redesigned display building. The ribbon containing all of the widgets has been replaced with a button, where the widgets can be added in the same way as adding matte modules in channel setup or functions in matte. You can also define a favorite list with the ones you use most often for quicker access. The software also needs to be intuitive. To help with that, we've moved managing multiple displays to a dedicated window and have introduced several convenience functions to help with creating displays. Tools like widget alignment, widget options, shortcuts for entering and leaving design mode, copy-pasting widgets, and even undo-redo functionality all speed up the configuration process. Since we want the user to always be up to date, we've made updating the software more convenient than ever. By simply clicking on the Check for Updates button, Dewesoft will connect to the web and list out all of the changes that have been made between the version that you're using and the latest stable release. The update will not only check for changes in Dewesoft's core, but also in all of the extensions that you've installed, so you never have to manually copy-paste files to update Dewesoft again. A lot of effort has also been put into the documentation. The user manual that's available via the F1 key is not only up to date, but is also able to provide better context help, whether you're online or offline. Even extensions can now open up the relevant pages of the manual when the F1 key is pressed, so searching the manual on Dewesoft's webpage should for the most part be a thing of the past.